going on, folks? Nick here with the Tierra Permaculture Vlog. I am finally back. It's been quite a few weeks. I've actually been back in Puerto Rico for 2 or 3 or 4 or 5 weeks now. It's been a while. What I'm going to do today is actually listen to a lot of what you guys have been asking me for, which is shorter videos. What I'm going to do today, right now, is actually show you guys how I just manage the chicken system I have in here, and just show you what I do on a regular basis to make sure these guys are happy and healthy. Before I do start that, I did want to do one more thing and make sure that you guys got to see Otto. Hey, bud. This is his favorite spot when I'm out here working. This is a shade cloth I have under here, and he likes to just come on up and relax underneath. Hey, bud. Hi. Good boy. Yeah, you sweet kitty. There's Otto for you guys, and before I keep going, I do want to thank all of you, all of my viewers, for getting me to reach over 1,000 subscribers. Thank you so much. Especially want to shout out to, see, I'm probably going to butcher this, so I apologize, but Jay Yorinmaru, I believe that's your name, Jay for short. Thank you, you are my 1,000th subscriber. I appreciate that so much, and I remember you saying that you really love the cat, and that's one of the main reasons you subscribed. Honestly, I'm sure about half of my people who are subscribed to me right now are mainly subscribed because of this guy. Good boy. Good boy, Otto. Yeah, you sweet kitty. And let's get started. So right now I'm in the chicken pen. So let me actually go outside so you can kind of see how I enter this bad boy. So right here, this is my chicken system. And I have the gate open right now, obviously. It's a very simple, basic system here. I have an egg box that I can access from the outside. There's just a little lid there that I can lift up. That's where I get the eggs from every day. I have my, all my feed is kept out here in just a stainless steel drum here. Keep any sort of rats or anything out of it, but allows it to stay dry, and not, so I don't have to worry about that too much. And right in here, this is where they hang out. Just come on in here. So my coop is actually very small. And it's actually probably too small at this point for the amount of chickens I have, because one of my hens, Henry, just loves to go broody, and often I don't catch her in time and I just feel bad and I let her go. So she's had another clutch of eggs. So now we have 11 chickens back here, 2 roosters and 9 hens. So we get about 6 to 7 eggs a day at this point, which is great in terms of eggs. Although we are often wondering, how do we use all these eggs? But we do find many ways to do that. So let's just check in here real quick. You can see this is one of the main reasons I need to get out here. Do you see how this is just completely disgusting in here? There's manure everywhere. This is not a healthy system. And speaking of Henry, you can see she wants to go broody again. She's in here. I've been trying to kick her out. You see how she's kind of getting puffed up like that? She's not wanting to move at all. That means she's probably broody again. This hen, Henry, she goes broody probably every month or so, wants to sit on eggs. And basically what I do to stop that is I just take the eggs out every day and I keep taking her off the clutch. Because sometimes we just don't want more baby chicks, especially right now where I'm living in Puerto Rico. So this is hurricane season. So I don't really want to have a whole bunch of chicks right now. Just in case a hurricane comes, when there's chicks, there's just a lot more management. And I don't want to deal with that if a hurricane comes and strikes us and then we lose power, we lose water, we lose access to normal shops and all that. So I don't really want her going broody right now. So we're not letting her. But when it's a good time to go broody, I certainly let her and she can go broody right there. But like I was saying, right in here you can see my coop. The bottom of my coop is actually, I use this kind of welded wire, you can see here. And this is actually too small. So you see, this is a 1/2 inch opening. This is too small. It should actually be 1 inch. So these 4 squares here, that's about how big it should be in order to allow the manure to fall through and have the system be self-cleaning. So this is too small. I wanted to experiment with it anyway because I had this on hand and available for free. So when I replaced it with originally I was just using chicken wire, just this stuff right here at the base. That actually worked really well because these openings allow for the manure to fall through much easier. So if I can find the 1 inch welded wire just like this, hardware cloth is also what it's called, I will go to 1 inch, but if I can't find that, then I'm gonna have to just switch back to the chicken wire. And I don't actually have too much predator pressure here. The main reason why you would want to make sure you have that, and you can even double layer it if you're worried about predators, is you could have a 1 inch layer on the top and then slightly offset just below that underneath, because I'm just basically using a 2x4 thing there. So you could have the hardware cloth on the top layer and bottom layer. That'll prevent any snakes or anything like that from getting through. We do have boas here, but the main kind of predators I have that would actually get to these chickens are the hawks, and they're protected by having all this shade place to hide and run underneath. And so I don't have to worry about that too much. So I don't have too much predator pressure, so I actually don't even lock them up at night. The only time I lock them up is when we actually have new chicks and I want to make sure that they're safe, because the new chicks can easily be got by many of the snakes that we have. But once they get to, you know, full size adults, the snakes don't bother them anymore. So that's going to be something I'm going to do today, is I'm basically going to clean out this whole thing so it's nice and clear. And we don't have all this extra stuff down here that can just kind of build up and cause some sort of disease to spread through here. So this will be my number one step today when I'm cleaning. The number two step is, you can see we've actually had a lot of rain the past week. And if you look down the ground here, you can start seeing there's a lot of bare soil. You can see a little bit of erosion happening right here. Of course, I'm going to expect erosion in my permanent chicken run area. That's just to be expected. But the way to help prevent this is to always have a nice deep layer of organic material, of mulch, of something basically to protect the soil and something to keep everything dry. The key here in the tropics, I'm in the wet, humid tropics, actually in a tropical rainforest system. Right over there is actually a huge tropical rainforest. So I have a lot of rain all the time, so I have to make sure I'm consistently adding organic material in here to basically make sure it's not too muddy. If it gets too muddy, it gets too wet and damp, their feathers start to stick to themselves, they can start getting diseases and just have some problems with that. So that's what I need to avoid here. So what I do is I go down to the local feed store and I buy a bunch of hay and I throw it in. You can see I just threw a whole bunch of them in there. And I just let them spread it out, but obviously they're not spreading it out very well. So what I'm gonna do today is actually spread out this pile of this new bale of hay all throughout here to make sure the ground is completely covered in a nice dry layer. That'll keep their feet dry, prevent any sort of infections from happening on their feet there. And it'll just kind of keep them happier and healthier overall. They actually like a deep layer of mulch. They like to scratch through it and find the insects that crawl through here. And with this system, the way I manage it is I actually have all of our food scraps, as you can kind of see down here, all of our food scraps, 100% food scraps, come into this chicken system. We just throw them right on in onto the ground. They eat what they want. The rest of it gets mixed into the bedding in here. And then long term, that becomes compost and soil for my systems right here on site. So all that's being, basically all of our food scraps going right back into our food production system here back here. And that's how we like it. So that's the first thing, is the coop. Second thing, the bedding, making sure I have plenty of bedding on the ground here. Other than that, I'm just gonna kind of basically clean up in general. So the other couple things I'll just note, I have a watering system here. This is a bucket. And it has these poultry nipples on here. These are really nice because I can basically fill this 2-gallon bucket and it keeps the water clean. And then anytime they want to drink, they just come and they basically peck at this, and you can see how the water comes out right there. It's a really easy way to make sure your water stays clean, reduces your maintenance of having to refill the water every day, because they definitely muck up the water. And I can show you that right here. I also fill this up on a regular basis, usually daily. This is their other water system, but you can see there, this was beautifully clean in the morning, and now look at it. See all that? See how it gets so dirty so quickly? That's literally maybe 4 or 5 hours later since I filled it up. I clean this every day. Every time I fill it, this is completely cleaned. This inside is cleaned. Nice clean water goes in, and then just kind of drips out. But see how they dirty that up real quick? I do notice they tend to prefer that kind of drinking style where they can actually dip their beak in. It helps clean their beak, so they do like that. That's why I tend to leave it and make sure they have access to something like that. But in terms of clean water, that's the way to go. Have a system that they can't get their beaks into, and it provides them a nice drip of water whenever they're looking for it. A couple other things I'll just note before I get onto my chores here is, right in here, this is just the feed. I just fill this up every day. So I do supplement their feed. We give them plenty of food scraps. They have plenty of food that they get just actually through digging through the food scraps and the mulch, all these insects that crawl through here. They get a lot of insects through there. But just to supplement their food, make sure they're always happy, I do give them food every day. And I basically just fill this thing up once a day, and that's all they need for 11 chickens. Usually they'll go through it all in one day, but that's sometimes there's actually leftovers depending on how much food scraps we add in here. And then just the final thing I do to keep them happy and healthy and producing eggs on a regular basis is I make sure they have access to a dust bath. So because I'm in the tropics, we get a lot of rain all the time. Instead of trying to keep something in that pen area really dry all the time and keep like constant supplies of some dusty material for them to use, what I do instead is I actually have an opening at the base of their run here For those of you who've been watching my channel for a while, you'll notice that this is now a garden, which was originally the bottom half of my chicken pen. I've actually converted it into a garden, and I'll explain more on that in another video. I'm not gonna get into that today. But so what I do here is their main run is up there. That's their main pen. And then you can see right along the fence line here, there's a little bit of a fenced in area. And then I have a gate right here that I can easily open and close. This thing just, it's connected to this post right here. I can close it up when I want to lock them in. That keeps them in at night. Oop, fell there, but that's how I keep them in. And then when I do want to let them out, I just come, undo that, unlatch it, and they can come on out. You can see down here, they're enjoying themselves. So this is basically a little area that they can you know, scratch around in, find some greens in, etc. And then there's also right underneath the house here, we have I have a natural dust bath underneath our house already. So instead of trying to create one and try to maintain a really dry area within the pen, what I do is actually just let them come out here on a regular basis. I make sure they get out here at least two or three times a week. It really should be more. Sometimes my schedule doesn't allow it, but even if it's just for like half an hour or so, I let them out and you'll actually see them always run right from their pen all the way down here. And you can see those two mamas right behind the roosters there. They're just dusting themselves, and that's actually how they keep themselves free of mites and other sort of annoyances. You see how they basically throw dust up in their feathers there. And so I have this whole area right underneath the house that I can let them go into. And that just allows me to have less maintenance in my actual chicken pen system, because if I were to need to replace dusty things with dry dusty things here where I get rain most days, sometimes we do have droughts 2 or 3 weeks where it's just like pretty much no rain and I could keep a nice dry system in there during then. But usually at that point, the actual bedding in there and the soil beneath the bedding is actually already dry. So they actually do their own dust bath just within the pen itself when it is dry out. But usually it's really wet. So if it has been wet for a few days, I basically let them out. They get to come down here into the little dust bath system and enjoy themselves, dust themselves, make sure they maintain their happiness. And then you see they like to scratch through here and look through for various insects and everything. They find some nice greens in here, and it's a good way to keep them happy and healthy. So that's how I maintain my system. I'm gonna mention one more thing that you may have noticed when I showed you Otto earlier, is above this system, you can see I have a trellis there. And on that trellis, I have two things growing. One is Malabar spinach, which you can see a very, very young version of down here. All these little greens are Malabar spinach. These are all vining green here in the tropics, but it's all up there. And then the other thing I have is passion fruit. Parcha is what they call it here in Puerto Rico. So right now I do have this shade cloth up here because that's what I started with before the vines actually took over. But if you look in here, and I'll show you Otto again. Hey, bud. The main reason I haven't taken the shade cloth down is because Otto just loves it so much to come and hang out in here. But you can see up here, this is just complete coverage of vines. This is a mixture of that Malabar spinach and parcha, that passion fruit. And at this point, I could literally take this down and it would all be protected by just the vines, giving them some extra shade, because once again, I'm in the tropic here. Tropical climate has very intense sun, especially in the middle of the day. So I wanna make sure they have a nice place to be out of the sun and protected from that intense heat. And so I'm just gonna take you right out here real quick to show you the top of it. You can see there, it's pretty much completely covered in vines up there. Again, that's a mix of the passion fruit and the Malabar spinach. And at this point, it's pretty much a completely shaded system. I could remove that shade cloth. I would just need to add a little bit more support over here. Right now, all that's just sitting right on the shade cloth, but add a little bit more support at the top on the trellis there. It's a fully shaded system. And that's it, folks. It's pretty simple, pretty easy. And I'm actually gonna start now and do all that maintenance, but you guys don't really need to watch me do that because it's just kind of boring old maintenance stuff. So hope you did like that video. I am going to try to do some more short videos like this. I don't even know how short this will be. Hopefully it was shorter than my normal ones, which are like half hour plus. Please leave questions below if you have any questions about how I manage my chickens, how I keep them healthy, and what I do to make sure they're safe and sound and all that throughout the seasons here in Puerto Rico. So hope you enjoyed that. And until next time, have a good one.